our slightly overdue 28,000 mile range update. Overdue just due to driving, and we were going to do the 100% at the Madison Supercharger. That just did not quite happen, and instead, because we had to get Gino to urgent care, we thought he had pink eye. Instead, it was just allergies, thank God. So, technically, 28,000 mile range update. The car is showing 278 rated miles. This is after doing a nice long supercharging stop, followed by more freeway driving, followed by then topping off on an 80 amp HPWC. So, 278 rated miles. External temperature right now is 46. It was about 50 when we started our drive. Let's see if we move over here. We are showing a pack remaining capacity of 80.7 miles. And the current balance of the battery pack is approximately 8 millivolts between the highest and lowest cells, and it's starting to settle and balance a little more right now as we are waiting. Now, it's too hard to see with that one. Yeah, it's better. Pack temperature, right now it's 89.1 degrees Fahrenheit, and I still don't understand the Celsius they got, because that is definitely not 2.6 degrees Celsius. It's cooled off a little bit by the time I got out here, and the charging taper at a on a HPWC as compared to a supercharger. When I started the top off charge to get this extra 63 miles in the pack, since I'm plugged at 98% at the supercharger, and then drove a bit more. The pack was at 109 degrees when I plugged in, and as outside temperatures are dropping, so are the pack temps. Let's see, what other information do I usually add? I think that is it to now. And, it's going into balancing. We're drawing a half amp at 402.39 volts. Which is basically the car is powering the DC to DC converter to charge the 12 volt auxiliary battery, of which the entire car systems are drawing 10 amps at 13.7 volts. So if you take 13.7 volts times 10 amps, that is 137 watts just for the privilege of the car to be powered up and active, not even running heat or any other functions at this time. And even if I was running heat, it would be running off the grid, not off the 12 volt battery. So that's some crazy power consumption